around the time of the 2018 NFL draft, I was really skeptical of a wide receiver named DK Metcalf. And for good reason, by the way. I mean, the guy was being massively, massively overhyped. The media were saying he was a top 10 pick, which was ridiculous. There was a big divide between the way reporters and the media saw DK Metcalf and the way NFL scouts and NFL evaluators saw DK Metcalf. Friends of mine, a couple scouts in the NFL, and a couple buddies, one of my best friends played D1 wide receiver. They all told me, this guy's not a top 10 pick. And here's how I knew there was a problem. All my friends were telling me he's not a top 10 pick. The media was telling me he is, but the media was saying this. Everyone on TV kept talking about how, and really everyone writing articles, everybody covering the NFL in general kept talking about how DK Metcalf has this giant muscle mass and all this weight and how strong he is and how great his body is. And no one is really talking about his ability on the field. They were getting caught up in the numbers and the nuance of how he looked. And in the end, here's what happened. He was drafted number 64 overall by the Seattle Seahawks, which is a respectable draft pick, right? That's the second round of the draft. That's awesome. It is also, by the way, the very last pick of the second round. But, you know, the media talked about him as a top 10 pick. And in reality, the NFL saw him for what he really was. A guy who's fine, who is, you know, exactly where he picked is where he should have been picked. The last pick in the second round. That sounds about right to me. Now, in the last couple weeks, I watched a lot of film on NFL teams. I watched, I was in the process of evaluating the Vikings running game, trying to figure out why the Vikings suck at running. And, one of the teams I did a lot of research into is the Seattle Seahawks, trying to figure out why what the Seattle Seahawks did better than the Vikings. And in that process, I learned a lot about how the Seahawks operate. And one thing that stood out to me is that with the Seahawks, DK Metcalf went to a perfect, perfect team for him. There are two reasons for me why he's a great fit with the Seahawks. Number one is a bit of a reach, I admit it, but the Seahawks offense is built around running the football. DK Metcalf has a huge frame, he's a huge dude, and I believe if they can teach him how to block, he could make a big impact in the Seahawks running game, blocking on the outside for their running game. I really believe that. Now, the number two reason, though, is the real reason why I believe DK Metcalf is a great fit for the Seattle Seahawks. Here's how the Seahawks operate. They heavily run the ball. They pound it down the throat of the teams they play. They run the ball, they run the ball, they run the ball, they run the ball. Then they use play action, they fake the run, and throw the ball deep downfield. I cannot think of a better role for DK Metcalf than being the Seattle Seahawks deep threat. I really can't. They love to take shots downfield. That's what he's best at. Now, I admit, I don't like DK's ability running routes. He has poor lateral movement. He's not a good technical route runner. He's really raw. But undoubtedly, his best trait is running in a straight line. He's good at getting open, running in a straight line. And the way the Seahawks use play action will create good matchups for him downfield. Look, DK Metcalf was not a top 10 pick. He never should have been even talked about as a top 10 pick. But I see him having some really nice catches down the road for the Seattle Seahawks this season. I believe he went to a perfect spot, and I think the Seattle Seahawks are a great fit for DK Metcalf.